listening to the sounds of the Jornada, a Catholic movement made up of young people who come together to celebrate their faith as they navigate their lives. Their journey may help to solve a mystery known as the Hispanic paradox. Princeton University professor Noreen Goldman studies it.
It represents the fact that Hispanics live longer than whites in the United States.
3.3 years longer than whites, according to the CDC, and 7 years longer than Black Americans, even though they face more socioeconomic challenges and have less access to quality health care.
That Hispanics have better health-related behaviors than whites. Predominantly, they're less likely to smoke than whites, but some have also argued that better diets are part of the differential that we see.
Experts are also looking at the power of prayer. An American Heart Journal study finding that prayer triggers a relaxation response, which can help prevent chronic diseases.
Another argument is that Hispanics have more extensive social networks, better social support through family, friends, or church than whites.
That's no surprise to Cincy Hernandez Cancio, who leads the health justice team at the National Partnership for Women and Families in Washington, D.C.
That social connectivity, which churches are very good at promoting, is very important for anyone, any family, in any community to be able to navigate all of the challenges of living in the United States.
Challenges that Father Manuel de Jesus Rodriguez knows firsthand. As the new pastor of Our Lady of Sorrows Church in Corona, Queens, a predominantly Hispanic parish.
They are united. They're still spiritually united with their family because of our faith. Well, as you might have heard, Latinos have a lot of health issues, not too much money, struggling in many ways. But Latino got something. Latina got a big heart, you know, wonderful approach of joy and enjoying life.
Another explanation, Hernandez Cancio argues, may have more to do with immigration than with the Hispanic population specifically.
Immigrant!
Power!
Immigrant!
Power!
Immigrant power!
When people come to this country, Hispanic or otherwise, they're coming in generally healthier, with better diets, and, you know, being an immigrant is a self-selecting thing. You have to have a lot of get up and go and energy and health to be able to come to this country to start a new life.
Those newly arrived immigrants, especially Hispanics, are using faith and family to help them overcome the challenges of their newcomer status.
Latinos in general tend to be much more focused on family no matter what. You know, hate the sin, but love the sinner. Latinos very much tend to be known for supporting their young people of whatever situations they may be in.
Young people like these members of the Jornada movement who choose to strengthen their faith through fellowship and cultural expression.
You know, it's that fellowship. It's that Latino culture in us, that family oriented that we have. So no matter who comes, we already, you know, welcome them with open arms.
It reels them in, whether it be through music, whether it be through performance art, whether it be through dance.
Be able to bond, especially with the faith that we have. We bond with our religion, we bond with our love for God, and it's something beautiful.
It helps us grow as a family, especially because we're a Latino community.
The Latino community has been especially hard hit by the ongoing pandemic, and their mortality advantage has suffered because of it. But there's hope the effects will be temporary.
Faith makes us joyful and hopeful. And that's, I think that makes life a little bit better and happier.
If you're watching Currents News on YouTube, be sure to hit the subscribe button and then click on the bell to get instant updates about all of our newest content, because we are putting your faith in the news.